Kylie Oye. I'm a member of Google's Webmaster Support Team. Joining us is my colleague and good friend, Tiffany Oberoi. Tiffany is a software engineer on Google's Web Spam team.
Hello, everyone.
Tiffany, thank you for offering to share your expertise. In the steps of recovering a hacked site, this video is to assess the damage, but with specific focus on the file system.
Yes. At this point of assess the damage, it's expected that individual URL examples of spammy or malicious content have been confirmed. Now, the often last but extremely important action when assessing the damage is to log into the file system for a more in-depth investigation. As you perform the actions in this video, keep in mind the question, what was the hacker trying to do?
I can see how if you put yourself in the mindset of the cybercriminal, you can start uncovering why and perhaps even where the damage occurred. Let's go ahead and log into our servers. If your site is online, you can take it offline again.
In this video, we'll end up checking for any modified or uploaded files on our system. If you have a backup of your site to determine which files have modified content, you can of course compare the checksums of the current files on your site with the files on the last known good backup. I'll guide you through a process of investigation. As you uncover changes by the hacker, take detailed notes on what files were altered or added. If your site was affected with spam, not malware, you can start reinvestigating, this time through the actual file system rather than through cache colon queries or fetches Google, the hacked URLs you found earlier. These are the hacked URLs listed in the Webmaster Tools message and that were uncovered with a site colon query. If your site was hacked to distribute malware, you likely already investigated each malware type provided in Webmaster Tools. As you investigate, be aware that the damage may not be limited to the affected HTML page, configuration files, or database records. The damage may be caused through a function in languages like JavaScript or PHP, located in a script or system file. As you locate these culprit files again, please take notes of the page and the hacker's modifications. After assessing the damage to specific infected URLs, begin a more general investigation of the server files that commonly provide more information about the actions and intent of the hacker. Take notes of everything suspicious, as it may help you in a later step identify the vulnerability. Check server logs for any suspicious activity, such as failed login attempts, command history, especially as root, the creation of unknown user accounts, and so on. Be aware that the hacker may have altered these logs for their own purposes. Next, if you haven't already, check server configuration files such as htaccess, httpd.conf for redirects, especially conditional redirects based on the user agent, time of day, or referrer. Again, be aware that there may be other helper files used by the hacker to modify the htaccess. Also, check folder and file permissions for two lenient write privileges, such as 777, which equates to world writable access. Often, hackers tamper with permissions in hopes that if they remain undetected by the site owner, the hacker will still have a way back into the site. In general, if you discover any folder permissions greater than 755 or permissions for world readable files greater than 644, make sure the looser permissions are really necessary. Keep notes of any changes you may want to clean up later. Eventually, you'll want to investigate your site, nearly file by file, or if you have a database, record by record. With databases, you can use tools like phpMyAdmin. Be aware that the cybercriminal may have modified existing pages or database records in a myriad of ways. She may have created entirely new spammy pages, wrote functions to display spam on clean pages, left back doors which allow re-entry to your site or that continue performing malicious tasks if not deleted, and unfortunately, many more damaging tactics.
If you have other sites on the same host or using the same software, please investigate those sites for similar damage.
Definitely, and after all the file system investigation, it's likely that you can answer the question, what was the hacker trying to do? If you confirmed your site's pages were compromised with spammy content, the hacker's motive is often clear. Exploit a good website to drive traffic to or improve rankings of her less reputable online business. Otherwise, with malware, you might determine that the cybercriminal was trying to direct your users to an attack site. If, however, you notice clues indicating the cybercriminal might have obtained or requested personal details from you or your visitors, such as with phishing pages, you might consider whether her primary intent was to steal confidential or sensitive information. Should this be the case, please note there will be a few additional steps in recovery.
This step certainly has lots to cover, but once the relevant actions prescribed are completed, you should all have a complete list of the damage caused by the cybercriminal, as well as a strong guess as to her intent. With this information, your site has good momentum to recovery. Please continue forward to the next step. Identify the vulnerability.